Bonjour tout le monde. Good morning,
good
everyone.
Morning, everyone.
Welcome. It's great to be home with all of you. Feels a little bit like a maritime kitchen party here this morning, doesn't it? And thank you to George and Tim and Carla, and thank you to everyone. Over 4 years ago, I stood in this very room with family and friends, including Prime Minister Harper and many of you who are here again today, and announced that I would be leaving politics. It was a tough decision. After dedicating most of my working life to public service, I felt it was time to step back and focus on my growing family.
Il y a plus que quatre ans. Over 4 years ago, I left politics to spend more time with my family and my kids.
I recently spoke with my son, Keon, who's six, about my decision to run. And I explained to him that this was a race. It was a competition that I hoped to win. And he said, well, Dad, I'd vote for you, but I don't know who else is running. I didn't know then that I'd be standing before you today, making this announcement. And I wouldn't dream of doing so without the complete love and support of Nazanin and my entire family, many here today.
I didn't know that I would be here today in front of you to do this announcement. And never I could have done it without the support of my family.
We're here today in the Museum of Industry, here in Stellarton, Nova Scotia, a place that celebrates the significant contribution of hardworking Canadians who sacrificed greatly for their community, their family, and their country. And that's important. It also feels right, for almost 23 years ago, I began my journey in politics right here. History and roots matter. People came here, to this place, from across oceans seeking a better life for them and their families. And through hard work, sometimes treacherous toil, through sweat of brow, strength of back, this country was built by that dream. The dream that here in Canada, no matter where you come from, fleeing persecution, poverty, war, or famine, you can have a better life for yourself and for your family. From waves of family, from Scotland, Ireland, France, and England, more recently, Afghans and Syrians, from people from every place on this planet, this country was built by our First Nations and immigrants. It was fortified by those who fled oppression in search of freedom and opportunity. Pictou County was settled primarily by Highland Scots, and I think of them today, particularly this being Robbie Burns Day. Burns famously said, "Oh, the gift that God could give us to see ourselves as others see us." Politicians, take heed. Ours is a great country, but while you are working hard and working harder for your families, your government is squandering opportunities. And those of you who know me know that there's something that my parents instilled in me at a very young age, like so many Canadian parents. You can't pass by a person in trouble or turn a blind eye. If you believe you can help, if you have something to do, be a good Samaritan, whether it be a neighbor or a stranger. It's the people who built this country, people who work hard, who take initiative, who know that the fruits of success are there to harvest if you keep on with determination. Ce sont les gens
it's
qui
the
ont
people
bâti ce pays.
That built this country, that worked
ils
very
ont
hard.
Ils savaient que pour
they went ahead.
De succès,
they knew that they would. For success, you need determination.
People, it's their dreams. It's your dream. And that's why I'm standing here today, again, to announce my candidacy for the leadership of the Conservative Party of Canada. Ce sont les gens.
People.
Ce sont leurs rêves.
It's their dreams.
C'est votre rêve.
It's your dream. And this is why I'm here today to announce that I will be candidate for the leadership of the Conservative Party of Canada.
We have a government right now that believes the more you succeed, the more you should be held down and tied up with regulation and bureaucratic red tape and taxed to the hilt, and the more your children and grandchildren will be indebted.
À ce moment, nous avons un gouvernement. Now we have a government that thinks that more than have the success, more than your dreams, we can stop you, limit you with bureaucratic rulings and more taxes and a bigger debt for your kids and their kids.
This government pits city against country, industry against industry, region against region. As conservatives, we have a different vision for government. We believe in a government that doesn't just get out of your way, it removes barriers and clears the way for growth and success. There is so much to be inspired by in this country, our athletes, artists, academics, among others. This is a country of doers, of builders, of heavy lifters, of winners. Canada's strong because Canadians make it strong. Canada's free because Canadians keep it free. And I'm proud to be a Canadian because Canadians make me feel proud. Recently on the East Coast, the people of Newfoundland and Labrador demonstrated in spades their ability to band together, dig out of a massive snowstorm. Here at home, I want to thank my neighbors, Mr. T and Seth, for clearing my driveway on Fraser Street. You know, some of the proudest moments of my life are seeing what Canadians have accomplished, both at home and abroad. As Minister of National Defense, I was deeply honored to do my part in supporting the men and women in uniform. And when I was able to visit them in Afghanistan and places around the world and witness firsthand what they would risk, how they would risk it all for strangers, I knew I was witnessing some of the very best of what makes Canada what it is today. I was honored to visit Canadian Forces and their families where they worked, trained, fought, and gave their all. And we know that the same determination, perseverance, and sacrifice was demonstrated by generations of Canadian Forces, giving us a hard-earned reputation as a generous, heroic nation. Canadians are soldiers, warriors, on ice, on sand, on forest and field, and because of it, out of an intrinsic loyalty to Canada, out of a belief that strength and compassion are core values of what makes our country great. Women and men can unite and go out into the world voluntarily, protect innocent lives from tyranny. I ask, is not our country among the greatest in the world? Our country, in fact, our entire planet, face big challenges with big, complicated questions being asked of us all. And yet, I see a federal government shrugging and often doing more harm than good. Virtue signaling without action, drama and rhetoric when all we desperately need are dramatic results. I can't take a pass or look away when our country is at stake, while this government makes life harder for our citizens. I can't stand by and hope someone else will do the job that needs to be done. And so, I'm here to stand up with you and do my part to help unite this country, to put shoulder to the wheel, and with others to help us build a better life for all. For Canada, of course, is a union of communities, large and small, of strong places made up of strong people who want a better lives for themselves and their families, of communities transplanted in timelines measured by centuries or days from across the world. We're made up of those who fled religious or political persecution, racial violence, sexual intolerance or exploitation, arriving here, leaving their homes and often their loved ones behind to begin a new life in Canada. For in Canada, we preserve, protect, and promote people's hard-earned rights. We never exclude Canadians or talk away their security or sense of belonging. We're spread out right across the continent. We fish in three oceans. We innovate, we plant, we produce. We supply the world with a bounty of natural resources that sustain our people. Nous créons une meilleure protection.
We believe in a better management of environment and a liberty and democracy, the best gift that we had as Canadians is the natural beauty of our country and its water.
The greatest gift that we've received as Canadians alongside our freedom and democracy is our natural splendor of land and sea. And what we have to offer is this: open arms, open heart, and an open way of life. Whether Scottish settlers or Afghan refugees, if you want a place to live and worship in freedom, where your hard work will be rewarded with the fruit of your own labor and the satisfaction of a job well done, where if you're willing to work with your neighbors, you can bind and build great communities, enjoy a better way of life. We're not a country that lives in isolation. I've taken part in negotiations on behalf of our country at NATO and UN tables. I know that we're part of a community of nations that believes in common ideals of shared security amongst the highest of priorities. And here among family and friends and allies, there will always be some disagreements on minor matters. We had some this morning, like socks. But it's truly the big ones that matter. And we all know that we're better for being part of a free world. And leadership on the world stage requires serious diplomacy. To advance Canada's interests requires authenticity of action, measured by outcomes, not selfies or photo ops or dressing up or dancing. For being part of a free world means helping people as much as it means giving people the freedom to help themselves. Les Canadiens,
Canadians,
en et en SC,
they have enough of a fake diplomacy that doesn't give any results.
In rural Nova Scotia, watching my grandfather in awe. He was a man, stoic in nature, who got things done. He paid his freight up front. Through blisters and bruises, he built a life for himself and for his family in Lorne, just down the road from here. He worked in sawmills, in forests, fields, and on the farm. And he believed, as Canadians do, that independence, self-sufficiency, and hard work are their own reward and a source of lifelong pride. And what he built in his time was a country where a kid like his could become a minister in the government of Canada, and where a grandson like me thanks, Pop. And a grandson like me would feel compelled by duty to keep building so that anyone born anywhere who works hard in this country can become anything they want to be and can build any life that they want to live. Believe me, I didn't begin my career thinking I would be a politician. Anything but. I set out to fulfill the dream that my parents have for their children. I went to school, I worked hard, I pursued a career. I later became a lawyer and then a prosecutor. And it was my job then to work with others to protect the public and provide safe streets to uphold the law. I thank all our law enforcement, military, and emergency responders with us here today. And you know, those years ago, I saw serious failings in what we have in our justice system. I watched as victims and survivors were often shuttled into the court, asked to have their say, and marched back out and try to get on with their lives. Their lives were often shattered by the crimes and sometimes shattered again by the harsh experience that they had in the justice system. I saw the need for change. And later, as justice minister in the Harper government, I worked to try to bring about substantive changes to help make our communities and our country safer. I can't and I won't watch anyone do harm to our country and not do all that I can to put an end to it. We've all lived through the realities of what can happen when conservatives are not united. We know firsthand how important it is that we do our part not to divide ourselves, our party, or our nation. If divided, we falter, we fail. And I've done my part, and I've played my part in uniting the conservative family into one big blue tent. And that's... Hey. For all conservatives, all Canadians belong in a party where they have a voice and a place at the table. Our strength comes from our shared values. And victory will only come if we work as one. The Conservative Party of Canada is more than a vehicle pulled together for electoral success. It's made up of dedicated Canadians, volunteers who help their communities every day. And we must be sure that the face of the nation is reflected in the face of the Conservative Party of Canada. When we unite, all for Canada, all pulling in the same direction, we can accomplish a shared dream. A Canada that is not just a great country, but a country that can become greater still, for our potential is unlimited as a nation. And if we don't unite, there is a risk to our party, but there is also a risk to our country, for democracy demands choice and competition. We are in danger of more years of Justin Trudeau, of more years of arrogant and disconnected Liberal governments making life harder for the people they say they want to help. And so I have a call to action for each and every one of you. It's the same thing that I ask of myself. Engage yourself in your community. Engage yourself in your party and your country. Canadians are calling out for a return to civil discourse, for citizen engagement rooted in respectful dialogue, free from fear of vilification for having contrary views. Unity and civility start with each and every one of us. And we'll discover that we have a lot in common. That includes our neighbor, which makes us stronger. Aujourd'hui, j'ai besoin que vous passez l'action.
That you move and you act.
J'ai fait également.
An act that I've done too.
Dans vos communities.
Get involved in your communities.
Dans la vie de notre pays.
Get involved in the life of our country, in our party. Canadians are asking to go back to respectful dialogues, a bigger engagement, without fear of defamation, even if we have opposite opinions. For each of us to be us, united, civil, and to act on a daily basis, we will discover that there's many elements that are uniting us. For my friends of Quebec, your dynamic is, can do a lot. I'm here to talk to you and give you hope, a hope of elect a national government that shares our values, that respects your competence, and that is proud of the place of Quebec inside Canada.
know that there are natural conservatives in every kind of family, in every community, in every corner of Canada, of every faith, in every place of work. And with your initiative, we'll listen to them to build a common vision of growth and opportunity, of a Canada that stands tall in this world. Together, we'll expand outward that big blue tent with strengthening its solid poles of conservative principle. Ensemble, on va gagner.
We will win and form a united government for Canada.
Together, we'll win and form a united, strong, and democratic government for Canada. You know, it's been proven time and time again that the only way that it will work, it's the only way that we'll win, is together. And so together, let's empower volunteers, constituency associations like ours right across the country, to shape the party. Let's empower the members of Parliament to represent constituents to Ottawa, not the other way around, even when it's uncomfortable. To speak truth to power, moving mountains in the right direction, and pipelines, too. And friends, we've seen how the concentration of power in the PMO has interfered with justice. It's failed Canadians. And has empowered only those close to the PM and his inner circle. The Liberal government has broken faith with Canadians. And let's be clear, we as a party need to earn the trust of Canadians to govern them with confidence for all. As we earn the trust to govern them with confidence and compassion, that trust will help us to make sound decisions as they pertain to Canadians' everyday lives. Together, unified, we'll get this country back on track to be that place, that bastion of hope for the world, that place where people can live in peaceful prosperity, safe from harm, prosecution, or intolerance. We can be that beacon that doesn't just call people to safe harbor, but stands strong in this world, weathering the storms, shoulder to shoulder with our allies, united against the enemies of freedom. I stand here before you today with my heart on my sleeve. For every Canadian, whoever you love, wherever you live, pour chaque Canadienne, Canadien,
Canadians,
où ce que vous vivez,
wherever you live,
que ce soit
and who
que
it is
vous aimiez,
that you like,
je donne, je vous donne,
I will give you my support, and I'm asking you to you work for, you give your contribution, efforts in this great adventure that will bring us to a more prosperous future and a better Canada.
I promise you my support, and I humbly ask for yours. Your effort, your input, your part in this journey that will bring us to a better place, a better Canada, and its place in the world. Merci,
thank you,
and God bless.